Hey guys, welcome to my channel Learn with Hina. So if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, then please do subscribe and press the bell icon to get all the notification about the new videos. You can also follow me on Anacademy. Just type my name Hina Jain and you can simply follow here. Now, in today's class, we are going to discuss about upward communication. What is upward communication? The function of upward communication is to send information, suggestion, complaints and grievances of the lower level workers to the managers above. Now, dekho, upward, up, naam se hi pata chal raha hai, up ka matlab kya ho raha hai? Upar jana, theek hai? Ab ye upar kahan se jayega? Lower level se higher level pe jayega. To usse hum kehte hai upward communication. Now, this upward communication can take place from a labor of a factory or employee of a company or the person working at a lower level. Now, he can give his complaints, his grievances, his suggestions, his advice and any other information or even the report whichever he has prepared to his superior, then to manager and top level management. So this is what upward communication. It is therefore more participative in nature. So this is more participative in nature. It was not encouraged in the past, but modern managers encourage upward communication. So past mein itna isko mahatva nahi diya jata tha, but in the modern times, modern managers are given more emphasis to upward communication. This is a direct result of increasing democratization. Now, what are the advantages of upward communication? Firstly, decision making. Upper management wants to know specific information about production, procurement, marketing, financial matters and so on before making any decision. Subordinates supply the related information through upward communication and decision making is made easier and quicker. Now, if at all any decision is to be taken in an organization, so the decision has been taken by the upper level management. Now, the information is being supplied by the middle level management and the lower level, middle level management mostly. Now, when they supply this information to their management, then they take the decision properly and it becomes easier for them because they don't have to collect information from anyone else, anywhere else, because their subordinate does this works and hand over the information to them. Providing counsel. Subordinate can provide their constructive opinion. Now, what they can provide their constructive means their innovative ideas to superior through upward communication. This kind of opinion may be useful to achieve the goal of the organization. Next, motivation. Upward communication allows the lower level staff to express their attitude or opinion. What they express their attitude and even their opinion to the top level staff. Resulting subordinate are influenced to work more towards the fulfillment of target. Feedback. Through such communication, the subordinate sent back the reaction to the decision sent by the superior. Thus, a top level employee can ensure whether the lower level employee have accepted the message sent by the superior. Now, they can even give them the feedback to their top level managers. Favorable organizational environment. Upward communication enriches the relationship between the subordinate and superior because there is a continued interaction between these two. Development of plan. Upper level management can collect information from the lower level management through upward communication. Information obtained from such communication can be used to develop and implement any plan. Next, development of creativity. Upward communication calls for a creative environment to grow where employees show their initiative for development. Now, what creativity? Now, employees create some ideas and they transform this information, these ideas to their superiors. So, it creates development of what? Creativity. Good relation. Subordinate express their opinion in terms of upward communication. Such communication gives a mind of thinking as well as the sense of belonging to the juniors. As a result, harmonious relationship prevails between superior and even subordinates. Now, when superior and subordinate would take care of each other's thinking and even about their feelings. So this creates a good relationship. Prompt appreciation. Because of upward communication, subordinate get some or many opportunities to praise their boss for any positive or effective moment. As a result, in cordial relationship between superior and subordinate. So there is a cordial relationship, there is good relationship. So this all is there between superior and subordinate. Knowing employees' attitude. Every organization start some welfare measures for the employees. If the upward communication is active, the top level management can know that how far employees are satisfied with the welfare activities, whichever is been given to the middle level management and lower level management. Next, the disadvantages of upward communication. The first one is distortion. Upward communication is intentionally distorted. It is what intentionally distorted. In many occasions, it is found that employees for their self-interest or to get relief from accountability edit the data or information before it is passed to the superior. For their own gain, they play with the information and they then hand it over to the superior. Such distortion hampers the real objectives of any communication. Unwillingness. Employees are usually reluctant to start upward communication. The manager should keep their door open, but they cannot force the employees to walk in their room. So he should keep the doors open, but he should not force his employees. If they are not willing to do a particular thing, he should not force them. Fear. Employees often fear that if they communicate their problem to their superior, it may affect negativity to their efficiency. The complaint placed by the subordinate may be interpreted as a sign of their personal weakness or limitation. So there is a fear among employees also. If they communicate some complaint about anyone else, or even if they discuss the problem which they are facing in the organization, chances may be there that they may have to face the consequences about the same. Bypassing. In the process of upward communication, once in a way, workers directly approach the topmost authority with their suggestion or by bypassing their immediate boss. This proves harmful in two ways. The officer who has been bypassed feels underestimated, while the top officer makes doubt on the worker's intention. So first one is underestimated and other one is worker's intention. The relation becomes poor between whom? Superior and subordinate, and even the work is damaged. Recklessness, taking the opportunities of the upward communication. Sometimes the subordinate behave deceptively with their bosses. It can damage the chain of command in any organization. So it can even damage the chain, because sometimes the superior may be behaving something like this which he should not behave. Even the subordinate will behave differently with their bosses. Flattery. In order to convince the superior, subordinate, they can take help of flattery. And for this reason, subordinate may conceal the truth and provide incomplete information to the top level. So he may hide the truth and give some information which is not truth at all. The decision taken on such incomplete information will be wrong to serve the organizational purpose. Next is insufficiency. Subordinate may not be aware regarding the sufficiency or the completeness of data. Insufficient information will bring zero outcome. So if at all the information is incomplete, then it may give zero outcomes to the organization. So next come errors and omission. Most of the lower level employees are not aware regarding many aspects of an organization. Furthermore, they bear fear to be a good communicator. During the performance of any upward communication, they may commit errors and mistakes. Now, most of the what they are saying is that the lower level employees are they are not at all aware of many things in the organization which is going on. So, they fear to deal with the things, and this leads to their performance that in a they there are chances that they may make mistakes or even errors in their work because of fear. Now, okay, we have discussed downward. Here, upward communication. So, superior is over here, and here we have subordinate. Now, upward means what? Upar jana. Okay, so subordinate say information is going up to whom? To their superior. So, please draw this diagram in your book so that it will be more clear to you. So, in the next video, I am going to discuss with you a chart of downward communication and upward communication, difference between both, and next we will be starting with horizontal communication. Till then, if you are having any doubt, please let me know in the comment section, and please do share all my videos with all your friends, and let everyone come here and take the benefit of it. Thank you.